Yeah. What's up with Nigga? What the fuck going on? Beat the man. I'm Tech Long. Shout out to Sauce Diddy. I still want to see you creative training.
So, what? Everybody always talk to you about jail. So I'm gonna talk to you real quick. We ain't gonna dive too deep
in there.
But basically, just explain a little bit to what was going on, like in jail time.
See, this time, this go around, I went to jail. I know if you go to jail.
How many times you been to jail?
More times than I can count. I've been going to jail since I was 20 years old.
So this whole process, you've been doing music, you've been to jail every time.
It's not a jail, it's not a jail.
So do you feel like your buzz go up every time you got out of jail?
Somewhat. This time now, though, it hurted me.
Why did it hurt you?
I got back the hole. I lost a lot. I lost everything. When I went to jail, this one of those state cases. Every time I went to jail, it was for the state. I'd be the justo or the workhouse or a county. I was in the feds this time. They took everything. Like, the feds, they played a dirty game. They could do whatever they want. It's the feds, the United States of America.
So when you got out, you ain't had nothing?
I ain't have nothing.
So I saw you probably like 5 days or 7 days after you got out of jail.
Yeah.
And you on the phone or whatever, rapping with them, and you got some paper and shit, and everybody holler, oh, that's murder money.
Yeah.
Why do people feel like you can't get no money like that?
I don't know, but...
Is it just because you ran it up so fast that people...
If we from St. Louis, they gonna hate like that. If murder just left. You witnessed that. Murder just left. And murder tell you yourself, he watched me run it up on my own. You know what I'm saying? I did it, like, in the streets. There wasn't no money from no label. None of that. I didn't have anything, a dollar to my name when I came home. They took cars, houses, everything.
So what did you go to jail for, burn it down for?
I went to... my first indictment was for a gun. A fugitive in possession. I never was a felon. I had a gun charge. That's what the feds first indicted me for. Then I got superseded on some old charges from years ago with me and Kells. That's how Kells was brought into the situation. Basically, it was for robbery, brandishing up my charges. This is my charges. Robbery, brandishing up a firearm, possession of a machine gun, possession of a firearm by a fugitive, a drug trafficking on weed. Bro, I had a bunch of fucking charges, bro. They just kept racking them up.
So, and with them thinking you was going to stay, would it have been a better situation if you would have got out and got back with them, or is it better now that you're by yourself?
Honestly, you know, I feel like, now that I see, you talking about cinematic, right?
Yeah.
Honestly, I feel like, now that I got to see, like, they didn't have the best interest at heart for me, because when I first started fucking with Cinematic, they, you know, we family, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. They made me feel like I was family, bro.
Yeah.
They made me feel like they had the best interest at heart for me, bro. And besides the music, they was gonna make sure I was straight. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So now that I got to see, I went to jail, I seen, like, they paid my lawyer, not giving it, they paid my lawyer and shit off all the way, like, out the gate, they paid my lawyer.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, God, they paid my lawyer. But after that, I didn't hear from Johnny Sykes. I didn't hear from Fabo. I didn't hear from nobody. Okay. I didn't hear from none of them, bro. I used to have to beg people, like, call for them, like, can y'all please send me some money? You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
I didn't hear from none of them, bro. Oh, God. And then after getting out and seeing how, like, after time was going by, and I started seeing, like, how I was slowly getting back those. Slowly. Then they basically trying to tear me and my brother apart. That's basically what they did, though. Like, because they got a hold on this. There's certain shit you can do. Like, even, like, when my first day out, with my cover art, his face was on my cover art. It was a problem with that.
They don't want you to use his name or nothing got to do with him at all.
None of that.
So they basically separated Benji Bam and Benji Kills.
That's exactly what it is.
Ain't no more Benji Brothers.
I ain't going to say it ain't no more Benji Brothers, but as far why he with them, I'm not doing it. I'm cool. I ain't going to do it, bro. Because that ain't how we started it, and that ain't how we going to finish it.
Okay.
They got so much say-so. You ask me, do I feel like it would have been good if I would stay with them? No. Because at the end of the day, it's just business. And I was just business to them. That's all I was. And that's what I be trying to tell my little brother. Like, it's just business at the end of the day. I couldn't say this back then. But I can say this now. You know what I'm saying? Because I ain't signing them. Who the fuck I ain't got to answer to nobody. I'm my boss. It's just business. So, nah. I'm glad I'm an independent artist.